The Government Savings Bank Act 1873, Act Number 5 of 1873, an act to amend the law relating to Government Savings Bank. Preamble. Whereas it is expedient to amend the law relating to the payment of deposits in Government Savings Banks, it is hereby enacted as follows. Short title. This act may be called the Government Savings Bank Act 1873. Act not to apply to deposits in Anjal Savings Bank. This act shall not apply to any deposits made in the Anjal Savings Bank of the State of Travancore, Cochin, and notwithstanding anything contained in this act, any law in force in the said state immediately before the commencement of the Part B States Laws Act 1951, 3 of 1951 relating to such deposits shall continue to apply thereto as if that law had not been repealed. Interpretation Clause. In this act, depositor means an individual by whom or on whose behalf money has been therefore or shall be there hereafter deposited in a savings government savings bank, and deposit means money so deposited. Secretary means in the case of a post office savings bank, the postmaster general appointed for the area in which the savings bank is situated, or if that area is in Pakistan, by the postmaster general for such area in India as the central government may by general or specify order specify in this behalf. Minor means a person who is not deemed to have attained his majority under the Indian Majority Act 1875, 9 of 1875. Prescribed means prescribed by rules made under this act. Deposits belonging to the estates of deceased persons. Nomination by depositor. Notwithstanding anything contained in any law for the time being in force or in any disposition, whether testamentary or otherwise, by a depositor in respect of his deposit, where any nomination made in the prescribed manner purports to confer on any person the right to receive the deposit on the death of the depositor, the nominee shall on the death of the depositor become entitled to the exclusion of all other persons to be paid the deposit unless the nomination is varied or cancelled in the prescribed manner. Any nomination referred to in subsection 1 shall become void if the nominee predeceases or where there are two or more nominees, all the nominees predecease the depositor. Where the nominee is a minor, it shall be lawful for the depositor to appoint in the prescribed manner any person to receive the deposit in the event of his death during the minority of the nominee. Payment on death of depositor. If a depositor dies and there is in force at the time of a death of the depositor a nomination in favor of any person, deposit shall be paid to the nominee. Where the nominee is a minor, the deposit shall be paid in any case where a person has been appointed to receive it under subsection 3 of section 4 to that person, and where there is no such person to the guardian of the minor for the use of the minor. Where a deposit is payable to two or more nominees and either or any of them is dead, the deposit shall be paid to the surviving nominee or nominees. If a depositor dies and there is no nomination in force at the time of his death and probate of his will or letters of administration of his estate or a succession certificate granted under the Indian Succession Act 1925, 39 of 1925, is not within 3 months of the death of the depositor produced to the Secretary of the Government Savings Bank in which the deposit is, then, if the deposit does not exceed such limit as may be prescribed, the Secretary may pay the same to any person appearing to him to be entitled to receive it or to administer the estate of the deceased. And within the limit prescribed under Clause A, any officer employed in the management of a Government Savings Bank who is empowered in this behalf by a general or special order of the central government may, to the extent to which he is empowered by such order and subject to any general or special orders of the secretary in this behalf, pay the deposit to any person appearing to him to be entitled to receive it or to administer the estate. Nothing contained in this section shall be deemed to require any person to accept payment of a deposit which is a time deposit before it has become due. Nothing. Payment to be a discharge. Any payment made in accordance with the foregoing provisions of this Act shall be a full discharge from all further liability in respect of the money so paid. Saving of right of executor. But nothing herein contained precludes any executor or administrator or other representative of the deceased from recovering from the person receiving the same amount remaining in his hands after deducting the amount of all debits or other demands lawfully paid or discharged by him in due course of administration. Saving of right of creditor. And any creditor or claimant against the estate of the deceased may recover his debit or claim out of the money paid under this act to any person and remaining in his hand and administered in the same manner and to the same extent as if the later had obtained letters of administration of the estate of the deceased. Security for due administration. The secretary of any such bank or any officer empowered under subsection 4 of section 4A may take such security as he thinks necessary from any person to whom he pays any money under subsection 4 of section 4A for the due administration of the money so paid, and he may assign the said security to any person interested in such administration. Power to administer oath. For the purpose of ascertaining the right of a person claiming to be entitled as aforesaid, the secretary of any such bank or any officer empowered under subsection 4 of section 4A may take evidence on oath or affirmation according to the law for the time being related to oaths and affirmations. Penalty for false statements. Any person who, upon such oath or affirmation, makes any statement which is false and which he either knows or believes to be false or does not believe to be true shall be deemed guilty of an offence under section 193 of the Indian Penal Code 45 of 1860. Deposit when excluded in computing court fees. Where the amount of the deposit belonging to the estate of a deceased depositor does not exceed 3000 rupees, such amount shall be excluded in computing the fee chargeable under the Courts Fee Act 1870, 7 of 1870 on the probate or letters of administration or certificate, if any, granted in respect of his property, provided that the person claiming such probate or letters or certificate shall exhibit to the court authorized to grant the same a certificate of the amount of the deposit in any government savings bank belonging to this estate of the deceased. Such a certificate shall be signed by the secretary of such bank and the court shall receive it as evidence of the said amount. Deposits belonging to minors. Payment of deposits to minor or guardian. Any deposit made by or on behalf of any minor may be paid to him personally if he made the deposit or to his guardian for his use if the deposit was made by any person other than the minor together with the interest accrued thereon. Receipt of any minor or guardian for money paid to him under the section shall be a sufficient discharge thereafter. Deposits belonging to lunatics. Payment of deposits belonging to lunatics. If any depositor becomes insane or otherwise incapable of managing his affairs, and if such insanity or incapacity is proved to the satisfaction of the secretary of the bank in which his deposit may be, such a secretary may from time to time make payments out of the deposit to any proper person, and the receipt of such person for money paid under this section shall be a sufficient discharge therefore. Where a committee or manager of the depositor's estate has been duly appointed, nothing in this section authorizes payments to any person other than such committee or manager. Deposits made by married women. Payment of married women's deposits. Any deposit made by or on behalf of a married woman or by or on behalf of a woman who afterwards marries may be paid to her whether or not Section 20 of the Indian Succession Act 1925, 39 of 1925 applies to her marriage, and her receipt for money paid to her under this section shall be a sufficient discharge thereafter. Miscellaneous. Protection of action taken in good faith. No suit or other legal proceeding shall lie against the secretary or any other officer of the government in respect of anything which is in good faith done or intended to be done under this act. Power to make rules. The central government may, by notification in the official gazette, make rules for carrying out the purposes of this act. In particular and without prejudice to the generality of the foregoing power, such rules may provide for all or any of the following matters, namely, the persons by whom and the terms and conditions subject to which deposits may be made in a government savings bank, the maximum limits of deposits and the condition as to interest or discount relating to deposits generally, or any class of deposits in particular, the non-accrual of interest on deposits when the maximum limits are exceeded, and the recovery of any interest paid in excess in the same manner as an arrear of land revenue or in any other manner, the persons to whom and the manner in which deposits may be paid, the form of nominations, the manner in which, the persons in whose favor and the conditions and restrictions subject to which nominations may be made, and the registration of nominations, the variation or cancellation of nominations, the fees that may be levied for registration of nominations and for variations or cancellation thereof, the manner in which any person may be appointed for the purpose of subsection 3 of section 4, the limit under class A of subsection 4 of section 4A. Every rule made under this section shall be laid as soon as may be after it is made before each House of Parliament while it is in session for a total period of 30 days, which may be comprised in one session or in two or more successive sessions. And if before the expiry of the session, immediately following the session or the successive sessions aforesaid, both houses agree in making any modification in the rule, or both houses agree that the rule should not be made, the rule shall thereafter have effect only in such modified form or be of no effect as the case may be. So, however, that any such modification or annulment shall be without prejudice to the validity of anything previously done under that rule.